Hey, this is How It Stacks here with Brian O'Halloran from Clerks, Mallrats, Dogma, all of the VSU stuff. I'm a huge fan. Thanks so much for sitting down and talking with us.
Oh, not at all. Thanks for having me.
Standing up and talking with us, more appropriately. So how are you enjoying Pensacon?
Loving it. Loving it. Like, really, everybody here has been really awesome and helpful, and it's nice to see the entire city turn out for this.
Yeah, I know, right?
Everywhere we went, restaurant-wise or bars, like, you know, staff is all dressed up as characters.
Yeah.
They have specialty drinks, you know, like Goblet of Fire drinks and stuff like
that.
The
police were directing traffic
with lightsabers.
I saw that not too long ago.
Lightsabers,
they're
directing
really
traffic with it. Crazy. It was kind of cool.
Is this your first time to Pensacola?
It is.
Oh, awesome. So have you gotten a chance to explore it all?
Just for dinner, usually. I went over to the Fish House one night, and then we went over to McGuire's another night.
Awesome.
One morning, we went out to Joe Patty's for breakfast, did a little shrimp and crab boil out there.
Oh, nice.
Tonight, we don't know where we're going tonight, but hopefully we can find another place, because I don't fly out home until tomorrow.
If you haven't been to the Tin Cow yet, the Tin Cow is amazing.
All right. That's a good suggestion.
It's very, very, very good burgers.
All right.
Kind of a gourmet build-your-own-burger kind of place. It's really nice.
All right.
So the main sort of meaty question that I've been asking everyone who's been kind enough to grant us an interview was the premise of our show is we take things that were cool when we were kids and rate how they hold up now.
Okay.
So what I was wondering is if there's anything in particular from your childhood, adolescence, or anything like that that you got away from and came back to and were kind of surprised by how you took it now. Like, after you've been separated from it for a while?
I remember one time a couple of years ago, I came back. It was just happened to be on Sci-Fi Channel or one of those channels, and it was Clash of the Titans.
Oh, okay.
And I was just like...
The original one?
The original one. And I was just like, man, no beef, Harry Hamilton, any of those guys. But I was like, wow, the special effects then and special effects now are not as... I mean, it's that classic stop motion monster. Yeah. I mean, the bring out the Kraken, and it was, you know...
Yeah.
You know, and then you look at South Park, I'm like, that's kind of like South Park almost. That was a bit of a surprise. I'm like, you know what? Sometimes it's not good to go back and look at things as a kid. You're like, that was great. And I'm like, oh, that was that great.
I went to one of the ones that we did on the show that really, really held up well from my childhood was the X-Men TV series.
Oh, yeah.
That one really holds up well. We do a lot of movies and TV shows and stuff like that. I was trying to think of one in particular that did not hold up well. I know we did an episode on snacks.
Okay.
And we did one on Gushers. Do you remember Gushers?
Yes, I remember Gushers.
Gushers are awful. They're terrible.
Yeah. It's a gigantic, edible paraffin wax that you can eat with the sweetest, most disgusting flavored liquids in it.
Oh, it's horrible.
And it's just, you would have been better off just smacking each other with them just to make it look like you're bleeding out of it. Like,
it's like a sugar zit.
Right, exactly. Yeah. It is like a sugar zit, exactly. But funny enough, Pixie Sticks still hold up.
Yeah, Pixie Sticks
and,
do well.
What was the Dippin' one where you had the little...
Dippin' Sticks.
Dippin' Sticks.
Yeah,
that's another thing that held up.
We tried Pop Rocks. And Pop Rocks didn't go over as well as I thought they would.
You know what it was? I think they've changed the Pop Rocks because they still sell them now at those retro candy stores stuff. But it's obviously it's not stuff that they found in a warehouse in the 70s. You know what I mean? Because I remember when I was a kid and that stuff, and it would literally like almost blow your mouth off. That's how much. Because you're gonna do the whole packet. I'm just gonna do a couple. You're gonna do the whole packet. And it's gonna be like literally like a shattering teeth.
Mostly
while
because
it's
you're
exploding.
A bitch if you don't.
Right.
You know.
And then of course they got to make you force you to drink it down with soda, as we all know, killed Mikey from the Life cereal commercials. Hey, Jibba Mikey, yeah, he drank Pop Rocks and soda, that urban legend.
Yeah, I know. But, man, so, again, I really wanted to thank you for coming to the convention.
Oh, no, not at all.
Agreeing to sit and talk with us. And, it's the Mallrats panel yesterday was incredible.
Oh, we had a lot of fun. It was a great turnout
for
that.
A total blast.
We got rickrolled by a young girl named Hannah.
And she almost got Michael Rooker earlier today, too.
Yeah, well, she did. She came over here and did it again today.
Oh, really?
Yeah, she did. And we went along with it. And I had the whole corner of this area singing along.
Oh, that's
so
awesome.
Yeah, she was awesome. She really was
it
awesome.
It was really cool. Like, that caught me completely. completely off guard.
I got the whole audience to sing Never Gonna Give You Up by Rick Astley. This girl came up to the Q&A and said, have you ever been Rickrolled? And funny enough, Jeremy London didn't know what that meant. And I don't know if Joey didn't either.
Yeah, so then she started to do it. It seemed like you were the only one on stage who knew what a Rickroll was.
Because I'm an internet troll. So, of course, I know what Rickrolling is. You know, that type of thing.
It was watching you explain the concept behind the Rickroll to everybody else on stage was one of the highlights of the con for me.
Once we explained it, we then sang it and had the whole audience singing it as well. So
it was fantastic.
Yeah.
Anyway, again, I just wanted to thank you so much for talking with us coming to the convention. I hope to see you again, you know, anytime you can make it.
If they have me back, I totally will do it.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much.
Thank you.
I really appreciate it, man. It's good to see you.
Same here.